going to this program, we first know the if-else condition. The program says that write a program to find the given number as positive or negative. But before getting to the program, we should know the if-else condition. So if this condition satisfies, then it will do something, or if else, it will do something. So this is the condition, if condition, if this condition satisfies, then it will do this task, else it will do this task. This is basically if else condition, and we will find the given number is positive or negative using if else condition. So if else condition can also be written as if else condition, means if some condition, then some processing according to that condition. If that condition satisfied, then we have to do this thing, else if some other condition satisfied, then we have to do some other processing over here. Else we will do the rest part. This is if else if else condition. You can give many else if condition in between this, means else if condition satisfy this thing, again else if condition satisfy, else if, else if, else if, then at last you have to give else. So we will be doing find the given number is positive or negative using if else condition. Okay, so I have taken the variable which is x. I have taken any variable, I have taken x which is integer type. I have given a printf statement like give a value, it will ask for a value, and scanf, it will scan a value. Means this is input output statement. I have left the processing part, and this is the return zero. I have left the processing part because and at the last, the output section is also included in the processing part. As because the processing part, the output is dependent on processing part. Means the number is positive. If the number is positive, then we have some output. If the number is negative, then we have some other output. So the output is dependent on the processing part over there. So we will be doing this positive and negative of two numbers using if else condition. So if the condition, what will be the condition? We can write greater than, we can write less than, we can write less than equal to, we can write greater than equal to, or we can write not equal to, or we can write equal to. For equal to in if, we have to give double this thing, equal to sign. For not equal to in if, we have to write not equal to. For greater than in if, we have to write greater than. For less than, we have to write less than. For less than equal to, we will write less than equal to. And for greater than equal to, we will write greater than equal to. Means you have to go by the sentence like greater than equal to, means greater than equal to, means less than equal to. We have to write less than first and then equal to. So here we have to find the positive and negative number. I have taken x, let x be something like 25. We know that 25 is positive, but the computer doesn't know that the 25 is positive. So what we will do, we will ask computer that 25 is greater than 0 or not. So we will write that x, because we have taken 25 inside x. So we will ask computer if x is greater than or equal to 0. Means greater than equal to 0. Or we will write if x is greater than 0. If x is greater than 0, then we will give condition print f positive number. If x is not greater than 0, then x should be less than 0. Then it will come under else condition, and we don't have to write the condition, because if this will not satisfy, then the rest will satisfy. So we will write else print negative number. So we can also do with the float thing, we can also do with this. If I take x as let us say minus 20, it will ask, is minus 20 greater than 0? It will not satisfy the condition. It will not go into if, it will go into else. Because this will not satisfy, then the rest of this thing will satisfy. It will go to else, else print a negative number. Let us take an example. If I write 0, x is greater than 0, 0 is greater than 0. 0 is greater than 0? No. It is not greater than 0. Then again it will give negative number. So our program will not run for 0. This is a loop, means loophole. So our program will not run for 0, as because 0 is a loophole for this program. So I have to modify my code something like, it should also react to 0. If I take 0 as positive, if in the question I write that let 0 be positive, then I have to write, if x is greater than equal to 0, x is greater than 0, it will not satisfy. But x is greater than or equal to 0, yes, x is equal to 0. So this condition will satisfy, and it will not jump to this, it will just print x is positive. So for 0, it will again satisfy. So it will satisfy for all the conditions. If I give x is equal to greater than equal to 0, as I have taken 0 as positive number. So I will write this thing over here. If x is greater than equal to 0, then print f positive number. Else print f negative number. The processing depends, the output depends upon the processing over here. Thank you friends for liking our videos. Do subscribe it, and for any queries just comment down below. And the raw codes which I am writing over here, you will get down below in our description section. Thank you.